Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here and today I'm featuring the new card kit by Spellbinders. In the beginning I was planning to make 10 cards, but you will see that I will share 3 more, and it was super easy for me to create even 20 cards out of this card kit, but the video would be about an hour long, so I had to stop myself at some point. So let's take a quick look on what you get in the kit. This is a pack of dies, there are 8 included. Some of them create little ornaments along with a string and a couple of circles, and others create a lovely poinsettia. It's a great set of dies, perfect for the upcoming season. Now let's take a look at the stamp set. This is a clear stamp set. It is Christmas themed. You get a couple of bows that you can layer one on top of the other, lots of sentiments as well as trees. Now you also get always a card like this, a leaflet, that gives you some instructions on how you can create one card as well as the contents of your kit. You get your double-sided tape as well as your foam tape, 10 envelopes and 10 folded cards. Now this is a pack of gemstones in lovely colors that match the color combo of the kit that has glitter on top. This is a pack of alphabet stickers. They have lovely sentiments, perfect for the season, and they are glitter ones. Hopefully I can grab the shine. And this is a pack of chipboard stickers, so they are quite thick. This has lovely designs that are perfect for focal points, and it includes sentiments and banners as well. Now let's take a look at the paper pad. This is a 6x6 paper pad. It's not double-sided. You get 2 pages of each design. And I believe there are 20 different designs, so 40 pages. I will be using this paper pad a lot in today's video, and some of the pages are specialty papers with beautiful foiling. And now let's take a look at the cardstock that you get. There are 9 different pages in a lovely color combo, including a gold one. And finally, I'm going to open up the die cut pack. This is the favorite thing from my Spellbinders card kits every month. I find it super satisfying to play around with all those cutouts and create lovely focal points for my cards. And this is exactly what I'm going to do for today. So I have spread out everything so you can take a good look of all the designs, and you get each design 2 times. Now as I'm laying them down, I like to create areas like here are my baubles, here are my trees, I have my flowers and leaves together, here is the candy all together. This really helps me out a lot when I decide to put together cards, because it is super easy to find what goes together. And let's start making cards. I am going to create super quick and simple cards that anybody can recreate them. So I'm starting with this beautiful pattern paper. I'm going to cut it down to size that's slightly smaller than a standard card. So when I place it on top of my red cardstock, it's going to leave a lovely border. I picked this die cut, which is a focal point that at the same time it adds a sentiment on my card. And I'm going to use 2 circle dies, one inside the other, to cut out a ring out of the gold cardstock. I'm going to stick the ring on top of my sentiment, which is going to give a nice border. And the paper has foiling, which matches perfectly with that ring on the outer edge of my sentiment. For the next card, I'm going to play with these 2 pattern papers. I'm going to cut out this to be 4.25 by 5.5. And then for the other one that has all that those houses on top, I'm going to decide how far I want to cut it out. And I'm going to use my scissors and do some fuzzy cutting. So I am following the design of the rooftops. Of course, if you don't want to do that, you can just use your paper trimmer and cut out a straight strip of paper. However, I think that this adds a lot of interest and detail on my background. I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back, and I'm going to stick that on top of my panel. And I have created a little village scene there. I'm going to use my scissors to cut off the excess paper. And to complete my scene, I'm going to use 2 of the cutout houses. I'm using foam squares at the back, and I'm going to stick them directly in front of that background paper. So it looks as if I have something with houses at the background, but some of the houses are popping out. Now I'm going to play a little bit with some of the options that I have as sentiments, and I decided to go with this one that says holiday wishes. I'm sticking that down with my Nouveau Deluxe glue, and of course you can use foam squares at the back if you want to pop it up. For the background I went with a dark red cardstock, and I always like to create panels like this one that are 4.25 by 5.5, and then I just stick them down on pre-folded white cards. And of course I have already 10 pre-folded ones in the kit. So I finished it off by sticking some of the gold stars, and my card is ready. Now I'm going to play with this pattern paper. It has a lovely pink shade to it, and I find that pink Christmas cards are very on trend lately. So I'm cutting this out to be slightly smaller than the standard card. I'm going to stick that panel on top of my card base. And this is kind of ombre. It has pink at the top and vanilla at the bottom. So on top of that, I'm going to stick my three ornaments. These are die cuts from the pack. And I'm just trying to decide where everything is going to go. And then I'm just going to commit and stick everything down. You can of course use foam squares at the back if you want to pop them up. I decided to go completely flat for this card. Now you can use a ruler and a marker to draw some strings, or you can use one of the dies that are included in the kit to cut out three strings, and I did that out of white cardstock, and then I'm just going to stick them down with my Nouveau Deluxe. I picked one chipboard sentiment, and that says all is bright, and I'm going to stick it over one of the ornaments. And you can call this card done, or if you want you can stick some stars here and there just to add some shine and extra sparkle. For the next card, I'm going to use this beautiful pattern paper in gray color with lots of sayings over it. I'm going to cut it out again, being slightly smaller than the standard card, so that's 4 by 5 1/4. And this is going to be a landscape card, so I'm making sure that I have the letters accordingly. I'm going to use Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back and stick it on my card base. And then at the top, I'm going to use one of the die cuts that says special occasion, and it has a lovely foiling on top. I'm using foam squares at the back to pop it as a focal point on my card. And then I'm going to use even more die cuts, such as those gold foiled leaves and the poinsettias. And I'm going to create a lovely flower arrangement. I'm going to tuck everything underneath that sentiment, and for some of the elements I'm going with foam squares to pop them up, while for others I'm going with glue to keep them flat. And here is the finished result. You can call it done, or if you want you can add some extra bling by using a few of those gemstones at the center of the flowers. For this card, I'm going to combine this beautiful pattern paper. I find it is very elegant. It has a lovely foiling on top of it. And I'm going to combine this navy blue with the gold cardstock underneath. And as a focal point, I decided to use one of the circle die cuts that says the most wonderful time of the year. And it is foiled as well. I'm going to use foam squares at the back to pop it on top of my card. And I think that all the elements that I'm using for this card were actually made for each other. I think they go beautifully together and they create a very simple but really elegant looking card. So I'm adding those white leaves on each side, and I'm going to finish it off by adding a little star just for some extra bling. For my next card, I'm going to create a little scene. This is going to be my background. Again, I'm cutting it out to be 4 by 5 1/4, so that's smaller than the standard card. I'm going to glue that on top of my gold card base. so I end up having a golden frame. And then on top, the focal points are going to be the two deer. And underneath, I'm going to use one of the sentiments. Now I'm just trying to decide the placement, and I love this pattern paper because it looks as if there is snow at the bottom. I'm using foam squares at the back to pop the little animals. And the sentiment that I picked says celebrating together. So having those two animals looking at each other and having that banner underneath, I think it matches beautifully. Plus, it gives that banner underneath their feet, gives kind of ground, so they don't look as if they are floating on my card. Now, you can leave this card as it is, or you can add some snow. I decided to add that with my gel pen, so I'm just adding little dots here and there, and my card is ready. For the next card, I have a 4.25 by 5.5 pattern paper, and I'm going to stick on top a white panel. Now, the paper at the background has lovely little trees, which are the exact same designs as the big focal points that I have here. So everything matches beautifully. I'm going to play around with all the cutouts, trying to decide where everything is going to go. For the center, biggest tree, the pink one, I'm using foam squares at the back. And for the other two, I'm going to use my glue and stick them down. Now I picked the sentiment in a similar color that says December to remember. And now you can call this card done, or if you want to add some extra sparkle on it, you can use the gemstones. I'm going to use the pink ones and spread them out all around the pink tree. And here are some close-up photos on this card as well. Now for this card, I'm going to use the dies from the kit to cut out poinsettias. I decided to go with white poinsettias just for the fun of it. I'm going to add layers upon layers to make them nice and fluffy. So there are three different sizes which I'm going to stack, making sure that I offset the petals. And at the center, I have cut out again with one of the dies some tiny little pieces out of gold cardstock, which are going to make the center of my flowers. And I will repeat the same process for the other flowers as well. I picked this beautiful pattern paper that is 4.25 by 5.5, so it is going to cover up completely a standard card base. And I'm going to stick on top the little poinsettias. And as you can see, I have cut out the same dies out of the green cardstock that was in the kit. So I can use bits and pieces to tuck them underneath my poinsettias to be the leaves. And the truth is that when it comes to poinsettias, they don't actually have petals. Everything is a leaf, just in different colors. So I have a lovely focal point at the center of my card, which I'm going to finish it off by sticking the word joy, which is a foil die cut. And again, here are the close-up photos for this card. And when I have all those die cut packs, I always forget to do some stamping. So for this card, I'm going to finally do some stamping. I have cut out a piece of this pattern paper with that beautiful design. And I'm going to stamp my sentiment, which comes from the stamp set from the kit that says with a little sparkle and a lot of shine. I stamped that with my embossing ink and applied gold embossing powder. And I'm also going to use another stamp, which is a little bow at the top of the branch, again with my embossing ink, and again I'm going to apply my embossing powder. So then I'm going to heat set everything, both the bow and the sentiment, and I end up having this lovely shine. At the back I used foam squares, and I'm going to stick that on another pattern paper, and you can see that the color of the berries matches perfectly the background paper. You can leave this card as it is, just stick it on top of a pre-folded card base, but I decided to add something extra, so I went with the red gemstones in different sizes, and I'm going to stick them directly on top of the berries. In the beginning, I was thinking that I should just cover up a few of the berries, like 2 or 3, but then I couldn't help myself and I just covered everything completely. And here is a close-up look on the finished result. And now this was supposed to be the last card for this video, but you will see that I'm going to share three more. So I used this lovely background paper, and on top I cut out a small white panel, so that this is going to help all the colors on my focal point to pop even more. For that I used one of the die cuts with all those books and the lovely teacup at the top, and I'm going to finish it off by sticking underneath another banner that says December to remember. Super quick and simple card, just like all the rest of them, and here are some close-up photos on this one. And the truth is that the more I make cards, the more ideas I get, especially when I have all those die cuts laying on my table. So just had to share one more card, and this time I'm going to use those glasses. They have foiling on top of them, and they are perfect for the New Year's Eve. So I'm going to combine this pattern paper with the gold cardstock underneath. I used foam squares at the back of the glasses, and I'm going to stick them there to be my focal point. And underneath I'm going to use one of the sentiments, and for that I'm going to use tiny little foam squares and place it directly on top of the glasses. And this sentiment reads celebrating together. Now I'm going to finish off my card by adding some bubbles coming out of the glasses. This is supposed to be champagne. So for that I'm adding little dots of glue with my Nouveau Deluxe glue, and then on top I'm going to stick gold confetti. So everything matches beautifully with all those golds on top of my card. And again, I couldn't stop, and I thought, okay, let's share one more. This time I'm using a leftover of this pattern paper, which I am going to stick on another red pattern paper, as you can see, and where those edges were met, I just stuck down the word Christmas, along with a tiny little sentiment that says Merry. And my card is done, super quick and simple again, and you can see a close-up photo here. And I promise this is going to be the last one for today. This time I'm going to use one of the tags, and I'm going to embellish it with some leftover poinsettias that I haven't used on the previous cards. For the small one I used a foam square underneath to pop it on top of the tag, and I'm also going to combine it with one of the sentiments, and this one says holiday wishes, and underneath the tag I'm going to stack the other poinsettia, the bigger one, this time with glue, just to embellish the tag even more. I used foam squares at the back of the tag to pop it on top of my card base, and you can see I combined it with this beautiful pattern paper at the back that matches the color of my sentiment. I tied some twine at the top, and I'm going to tie a little bow there. Finally, I'm going to stick that on a red panel, so I end up having a lovely border that matches the color of my poinsettias, and I'm going to call this card done. Okay, and at this point I had to force myself to stop making cards, otherwise it would take me forever to do this video editing. So let's take a close-up look on all the 13 cards that I made for today, while playing with the products that were included in the Spellbinders new card kit. I absolutely love the designs, and the Spellbinders kits are great money for value, for sure. I could make many more cards, and once you see all of them here, I'm going to show you all the leftovers. So you can see here I have tons and tons of more die cuts to create even more cards. I do have stickers and gemstones. Of course, I can use again and again the dies. I haven't even used the ornaments here. So it is a kit I would definitely recommend, and I'm sure you will have fun playing with it. Don't forget, you will find links to this card kit down below in the description area. Make sure to comment, like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. I hope you had fun today and that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.